Hey YouTube, Stu B520 here. Canik TP9 SF Elite range review. Woo! Let me tell you, good shooter. Empty mag, empty chamber, empty magwell. This gun is clear. Yeah, so four different defense rounds. I had my Winchester 147 grain jacketed hollow points. That's my current carry round. I had Winchester silver tip jacketed hollow point, so another defense round, 115 grain. Yeah, 115 grain. I had critical defense, 115 grain. See, a nice little flower there. And I had PMC bronze jacketed hollow points. I didn't know they made a jacketed hollow point. So, four different defense rounds. I already showed clear on the gun. And I took 3, 3, 3, and 3. And then a couple, enough to make 20. 3, 3, 18. And then two other oddballs. I don't know what it was. One of these, but I put them in like this, you know, staggered like that. I didn't put the three together. I put one of these, one of these, one of these, and then one of these. And with my jacketed hollow point 147 grain Winchesters. So that was the first two mags. And check this out, 12 yards. 10 at the least, 10 to 12 yards. Whoa. For the first time in about 5 years, really putting some trigger time. Oh, I don't know if I want to say trigger time, but some time behind the trigger of a striker fired pistol. That's pretty good for me. 10, 12 yards. I'll take that any day of the week on a pistol I ain't shot in a dog's age. And then the rest, I ended up putting about 220 rounds total through the pistol. The rest were just functions checking, mag dumps, double taps, triple taps, quick reload, making sure everything functions. And I had, for range ammo, I had cellular embolot, 124 grain. 124 grain, yep. And I had some of American Eagle, Federal American Eagle, 115 grain. And at the range, they had some of their remanufactured stuff that I put through it too. I got a bag of 50 that they're selling, 17 bucks. I guess that's cheap, 17 cents a round versus 34 or 64 cents a round. But in any event, 220 rounds total. Man, I'm pretty happy with that. I mean, I feel like I shot this better than I do any of my hammer-fired pistols. I mean, you saw if you watched the last video, or the video prior to the unboxing of this one, where it was the CZP07 and the Beretta PX4 Storm Compact versus. I showed you those targets, and I didn't shoot those too well. But this one, man, I'll tell you what. Make sure it's clear. It is. Empty. This one. Tell you what. It felt good to shoot it. I mean, I kind of did a lot of rapid fire, you know, Such and Honest Outlaw talking about ejection patterns. And I had one hang up in the first two rounds with the hollow points, with the defense rounds. But it wasn't an ejection issue. It was more of it didn't want to go into battery. It hung up. It was kind of like that. But as soon as I banged it home like that, it went, and I didn't have not one malfunction after that. So 220 rounds, one hang up was just didn't go into battery, and I just gave it a pop. But I did have a ejection pattern where it wasn't consistent. They all ejected, but and I had a couple come right back in my face. So I don't know if it was if there's a break-in period or not, but it was just one or two. One it kind of did a pinball off the inside of my eye and my glasses, but it fell right out, and thank God it didn't burn me, the hot casing. But in any event, a couple hit me in the hat, in the head, dinged off my my earmuffs, my ear protection. But everything ejected. I was really happy about that. I thought I might get some stovepipes and failures to eject, but I didn't. It ran really good. I was happy with it, and I shot it pretty good, in my mind, for me. So I don't know. I don't know. It's a nice gun. Whilst I was at the range, this range has a gun shop as well. It's not my local gun shop where I do my business. But I was looking in the case, and they had a brand new. It looked just like this, but it was black. It was the TP9DA, and it was the decocker. And I guess it's the version 2 of the V2. I was talking about it last time. The decocker, double action, single action, striker fired pistol with a decocker. And I said that would be right up my alley. You know, I'd like to get my hands on one. Well, this was the TP9DA. So DA is for double action, and it had a decocker on it, and it was really nice. It was kind of expensive, I thought. It wasn't that expensive compared to the Glocks that it was sitting next to, and the Sig Sauer that it was sitting next to, and a couple of those Smith and Wessons. I think it was like $475, but it comes with a kit. I think you got three mags, you get the holster. I mean, I did the unboxing on the other one, and it had a whole bunch of stuff in it. But I think this one comes with pretty much the same stuff. But I think you get three mags in the box, the holster. It might even have a cleaning kit with it, not just a bore brush and a patch rod, cleaning rod. So I don't know, but it was nice looking, and it looked just like this, pretty much the same thing. But I'm not in the market yet for another pistol. I just got three new ones, the Storm Compact, the CZ P07, and this one, so I'm good for a little bit. This is a good gun, man. Let me tell you, I'm happy with that. So 220 rounds, whole bunch of different defense loads, jacket and hollow points, critical defense, ball ammo, and the Honest Outlaw and Such, they were talking about that how it preferred 124 grain. They were saying the 115 grain was what they were having most of the issue with. So I brought the Cellier and Balot with me. I put this is 124 grain. But all the hollow points are, with the exception of my Winchesters, the current carry round, everything else was 115 grain, and it ran pretty good. I had no problems other than that one out of battery. I just gave it a pop home, and it functioned pretty much flawless, and I'm pretty happy with that. You guys got any experience with Canik? I'd love to hear it. I know there's a lot of videos on Caniks. Lots. I've been watching them like all day long at work. I have the luxury to sit and watch YouTube videos in my downtime. So anyway, Canik TP9 SF Elite. Once the holster comes in, will I consider it into the carry rotation? Most definitely. I would even more so consider it if I could find the decocker and have a double action, because, you know, I have a thing where one of the reasons why I got away from the striker fire, one of the reasons, because I didn't like holstering and getting caught that easy trigger on a shirt or anything really. And with the double single action hammer fired pistols, the first draw is like a revolver. I mean, that's the safety on it. You know, it's a really heavy pull. You really have to want it to pull. And when you holster a hammer fired pistol, you put your thumb on the hammer, and you and it's not gonna get caught. You're gonna feel it with the tension, and you're not, and it's not gonna go off. So, but you know, I'm definitely gonna. This is gonna get the holster's coming. I got it off eBay. I'm gonna do a review on that. I think a couple videos back, I said I'd do a holster review and talk about my EDC setups and stuff, which isn't elaborate. It's just the holster, and if I decide to stick an extra mag in my pocket, but I'll at least show you my holster and how I carry, possibly in the next video. But this was a great pistol, great shooter. Look, three different defense rounds. PMC bronze, Winchester silver tip, critical defense. Those are all 115 grain, and my Winchester's 147 grains, jacket hollow points. Great gun. Canik TP9SF. Thank you. Have a great night.